Think about that one thing you've always wanted to do for a living. This could be a passion project you'd do anything to be a part of, or maybe a dream job that just thinking about makes you come alive. Now, imagine yourself in the following scenario. You're out at a party or a social gathering with some friends, and you strike up a random conversation with someone who just so happens to have all the connections and all the resources necessary to put you in the very position you dream of being in. I mean, this is the type of person who can change your life with a single phone call. This is the kind of person who can write a check without batting an eye that would finance any one of your projects. And the best part of all, they're actually interested in hearing about your ideas. Tell me, what are you up to in the world, they say. Your eyes light up as you think about all these creative ideas that have been swimming around in your head for years. And you say, I'm just brimming with creative ideas. So I've been thinking about starting a nonprofit that's devoted to helping out artists because I believe that creative people are the ones who drive social change. And I've got a couple of startup ideas too. I'm thinking about a business venture on this, a business venture on that. I was talking with my buddy about this idea over here. And you go on for several minutes talking about all of these cool, creative ideas, and at the end of the conversation, that person says, I like the way you think. Here's my business card. By the end of the week, shoot me an email with some examples of your work, and I'll share it around in my network, and we'll see if we can show some support. At that moment, how do you feel? Are you excited about sending them an episode of that podcast you've been working on for the past several weeks? Are you pumped up about getting a fresh set of eyes to read that new ebook you recently published? Or maybe you're nervous about sending them that YouTube video that you had to record in your apartment because you didn't have access to a high-quality production studio. Or maybe you're nervous that when you send them your blog, they're gonna scroll through all your old posts and see how bad of a writer you were a year ago. Or maybe it's worse than that. Maybe you're completely stumped because you have nothing to show for your passion at all. This world is full of people who claim to be passionate about doing a particular thing for a living, and yet there is one common problem that plagues many of the people who fall into this category. Apart from what they say or write on their resume, their talent is a secret. They say, I want to be a writer. And there's no evidence anywhere of them having ever written anything. They say, I want to be an actor or a musician. And there's no evidence anywhere of them having performed anything. They say, I want to be a journalist. I want to be a marketing director. I want to be a comedian, a public speaker, or whatever it is. And there is no proof to be found that they're good at those things or that they're committed to developing the necessary skills. That is a problem. It's a problem because it puts the people who have the power to support you in the unenviable position of having to take your word for it, of having to exercise blind faith in what you say you're able and willing to do. Now, as nice as it would be to live in a world where we could all just say, hey, I'm passionate about this, and then have people throw money and support at our feet, that's a huge risk because in the marketplace, there's competition. For anything you want to do, there are other people out there who want to do the same or similar things. And if any of those people are willing to show evidence of their work, that means you're the one who loses out on an opportunity. When you can say, hey, look, here's something I've already created, or here's something that I'm in the middle of working on right now, it allows people to preview your work before they agree to pay you, or before they put their reputation on the line. Even if your work isn't perfect or completely polished, it signals character. It demonstrates to other people that you're the kind of person who is creative enough, ambitious enough, persistent enough to find a way to get things done, even in less than ideal conditions. It shows that you're not just a bunch of talk. I want you to put yourself in other people's shoes for just a moment. Let's imagine that you've worked very hard to earn the trust and respect of some very influential people. You've built so much social capital that you could go to those people, make a recommendation, and they will take you seriously because of the person you are. Now, you have two people who come to you looking for opportunity, and they want you to put your hard-earned reputation on the line by recommending them to the people you know. Which of the following two people do you feel most comfortable recommending? Person number one. This is someone that doesn't have a lot of money, but they have a ton of motivation. They're capable of making excuses, but they refuse to make any. And even though they don't have a lot of resources and support, they use everything at their disposal to put together some kind of version, some kind of tangible representation of their idea. So even if it's low quality, other people can look at it and they can see that it took a lot of commitment to get there. And they can also imagine how much better it would be if someone came along and put some resources behind it. That's person number one. Person number two claims to be very gifted. They say that they're very passionate. They talk a big game, but they haven't done anything that's verifiable. And when you ask them, hey, why haven't you done anything? They say, oh, you know, when I do something, I like to do it right. And so I'm just waiting for the money to come in, and then I'll show this world what I can do. Now, we don't have to dismiss person number two as a bad human being, but it should be quite easy to see that this person is gonna have a much more difficult time to win your confidence over person number one. You see, it takes talent and passion to do what you love, but it also takes work ethic and reliability. And before other people feel motivated to pay you for something, they want to see some kind of evidence that you're willing to invest in yourself. And your body of work speaks much louder on any day of the week than your words. So, if you want to get paid for something, start working on it like you're already getting paid before anyone writes the first check. If you want to do something for a living, find a way to live what you want to do, even when circumstances are difficult. Now, you may be thinking, yeah, but if I start now, what if I do it poorly? Well, if an opportunity is what you're looking for, nothing matches the description of doing it poorly more than refusing to do it at all. If you want other people to take a chance on you, you have to be willing to bet on yourself. The world will not crave your talents because of what you wish for. It will only demand your gifts because of what you're willing to work for. Opportunity doesn't react to what you say, it responds to what you show. If you want to know the pleasure and the freedom of doing what makes you come alive, you can't sleep on your potential. If you want to follow your dreams, you've got to start working on them as if you're already awake.